So hi everyone, welcome to the session of Linear IC applications. And in today's session, I am going to give the demo on AC analysis of single input balanced output and single input unbalanced output differential amplifier. And in previous class, already we have seen the AC analysis of dual input balanced output configuration and dual input unbalanced output configuration. So in the similar manner, by using the same rules, we are following the same rules here also. By using those rules, we should perform the AC analysis for the third configuration. So this is the third configuration. Here this figure represents the single input balanced output differential amplifier. So single input means we are applying only one input to the differential amplifier, and we are taking the output between two collectors. Single input means we are applying single input, one input. And balanced output means we are taking the output between two collectors. So from this figure, we can observe that here we are applying the input signal V1 to the first transistor, and the second transistor input is zero. The second transistor is connected to ground, base is connected to ground. So that is the input for the second transistor is zero, second input is zero. We are applying a single input for the differential amplifier, and we are taking the output between two collectors. So this is the output point. So VO1 and VO2 represents the output voltages. So here the differential amplifier amplifies or produces the difference between two input signals. So for the single input balanced output differential amplifier, we are applying a single input and we are taking the output between two collectors. Okay, input is the mama, two collectors degar output is kundamu. So ilanti configuration ni single input balanced output differential amplifier. So next, this figure represents the AC equivalent circuit of single input balanced output differential amplifier. So AC equivalent circuit means we are following some rules in order to perform the AC analysis. By following that rules, we should draw the AC equivalent circuit. So what are the rules? So first rule is to perform the AC analysis, we should make the DC sources as zero. So to perform the AC analysis, we should make the DC sources as zero. Mainly we have two DC sources here. One is VCC, another one is minus VEE. We should maintain these DC sources as zero. That means these two voltages must be zero. That means these terminals are connected to ground. Next, we should substitute T equivalent model in place of these two transistors. We should substitute T equivalent model in place of these two transistors, Q1 and Q2 transistors. So if you follow that, if you follow the two rules of AC analysis, then we can get the AC equivalent circuit as shown in the figure. So already we know this portion represents the AC equivalent circuit, T equivalent model for the first transistor. This portion represents the T equivalent model for the second transistor. So idi AC equivalent circuit amma, idi raavali ante manam two rules follow avali. Enta rules? AC analysis perform cheyali ante two rules untayi. First rule enti, DC sources ni zero cheyali. DC sources ante em unnai? VCC and minus VE, avi rendu kuda DC sources, aa rendittini zero chestam, ante aa rendu terminals ni ground connect cheyali. Next T ante transistors edaithe unnayo aa transistors place lo T equivalent model ni substitute cheyali. So ikkada manaku two transistors unnai, Q1 and Q2. So our two transistors place to T equivalent model place chestam. Idi T equivalent model first transistor ki, idi T equivalent model second transistor. So here normally the transistor consists of three terminals: base, collector, emitter. So this is the collector terminal of first transistor, and for the collector we have only one resistor, that is RC. For the collector, from the figure, for the collector we have only a resistance RC. So that is RC. The current flowing through this collector terminal is IC1. So RC1 is equal to RC2 is equal to RC. Here we are taking the resistances in same manner. So that is RC1 is equal to RC2. So RC is the collector resistance, and the current flowing through the collector terminal is IC1. Next, for the base terminal we have two components. V1 and internally we have the resistance, that is RN1. V1 and RN1. So we can also take it as VN RN. for the simplicity, we can take it as Vin, Rin. So these are the two components which we have for the base terminal. And for the collector terminal, we have the emitter resistance. From the figure, for the emitter terminal, we have the emitter resistance. This is the emitter resistance of first transistor. This is common for the second transistor also. We have common emitter terminal for both the transistors, Q1 and Q2. And for the emitter terminal, we have the emitter resistance R. So that is, for the emitter terminal, we have the emitter resistance R, capital R. And we should take the internal resistance also. Internal resistance of emitter, that is small Re. Also we should take. So this is the T equivalent model for the first transistor. Similarly, this is the T equivalent model for the second transistor. And already we know the emitter terminal is common for both the transistors. So we have common Re for both of these transistors. Re is same for both the transistors. This is the emitter terminal for the second transistor also. And here we have capital Re, the internal resistance of emitter is small Re. And next, for the base terminal, we are connecting the base terminal to ground. So that means we have no components for the base terminal. So just simply connect the base terminal to ground. Connect the base terminal to ground. And as well as for the collector terminal, we have the collector resistance. For the collector terminal of C2, we have the collector resistance RC. And the current flowing through this terminal is IC2. So here we should observe the current directions. We have only one voltage source here because we are applying a single input, and that input is applied for both the circuit or for both the transistors. For the whole circuit, we are applying a single voltage. So that means the current passes from this direction to this direction. So this is the current direction. For the collector also, this is the current direction. For the balanced output or for the dual input, we can get the current as in this manner. The current direction is in this manner. But for the single input, we are applying a single input. That means one input. So this source is common for both the, that means this is the main source for all for two transistors, for both of the transistors. So that means the current flowing from V1 to the whole cell. This is the current direction. So this is the AC equivalent circuit of single input balanced output configuration. We are applying a single input V1, and we are taking the output between two collectors, C2 and C1. This is C2, this is C1. We are taking V0, that is output voltage, between these two collectors. So ఇది AC equivalent circuit అండి. ఇది ప్రీవియస్ గా నేను ఆల్్రెడీ చెప్పున్నాను. ఇది ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ T equivalent circuit. ఇది సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ T equivalent circuit. So ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ కి మనకి నార్మల్ గా 3 టెర్మినల్స్ ఉంటాయి. సర్క్యూట్ లో ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో ఆ టెర్మినల్స్ ఉన్న కాంపోనెంట్స్ మనం ఇక్కడ కనెక్ట్ చేస్తాం. కలెక్టర్ కి కలెక్టర్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటుంది. దానిలో ఫ్లో అవుతున్న కరెంట్ IC1. బేస్ టెర్మినల్ కి 2 కాంపోనెంట్స్ కనెక్ట్ అయి ఉన్నాయి. V1 అండ్ RN1. ఆర్ V1 ఆర్ RN అన్న చెప్పొచ్చు. అండ్ ఇది ఇంటర్నల్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ అండి. నెక్స్ట్ దీనిలో ఫ్లో అవుతున్న కరెంట్ IB1. నెక్స్ట్ ఎమిటర్ కి ఒక రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటుంది క్యాపిటల్ RE. అండ్ ఇంటర్నల్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ కూడా మనం ఇక్కడ తీసుకున్నాం స్మాల్ RE. ఇది ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ యొక్క T ఈక్వివలెంట్ మోడల్. అండ్ ఎమిటర్ అనేది కామన్ రెండిటికి, అంటే ఒక రెసిస్టెన్స్ మాత్రమే ఉంటుంది మనకి ఎమిటర్ కి రెండిటికి కలిపి. సో దట్ ఈస్ క్యాపిటల్ RE. నెక్స్ట్ దానికి ఇంటర్నల్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ స్మాల్ RE కూడా తీసుకోవాలి. నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ బేస్ కి మనం ఏం కనెక్ట్ చేయట్లేదు. V2 is 0. సో అంటే బేస్ ని డైరెక్ట్ గా గ్రౌండ్ కి కనెక్ట్ చేస్తాం. నెక్స్ట్ ఇది కలెక్టర్. సో సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ యొక్క కలెక్టర్, కలెక్టర్ కి ఏం కనెక్ట్ అయ్యింది? RC కనెక్ట్ అయ్యింది. సో RC కనెక్ట్ చేసాం. కరెంట్ వచ్చి IC2. ఇది ఈ డైరెక్షన్ లో ఫ్లో అవుతుంది బికాస్ ఇక్కడ మనం ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి ఈ కరెంట్ అనేది ఈ డైరెక్షన్ లో వస్తుంది. VCC - VE 0 అండి. అంటే RC అదర్ టెర్మినల్ గ్రౌండ్, ఈ RC అదర్ టెర్మినల్ గ్రౌండ్ కూడా గ్రౌండ్, RE అదర్ టెర్మినల్ గ్రౌండ్. RE నార్మల్ గా -VE కనెక్ట్ అవుతుంది, -VE 0 కాబట్టి ఇది కూడా గ్రౌండ్. సో ఇదంతా గ్రౌండ్ పోర్షన్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద AC ఈక్వలెంట్ సర్క్యూట్ ఆఫ్ సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. వి ఆర్ అప్లైయింగ్ ఏ సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ అండ్ వి ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద అవుట్పుట్ బిట్వీన్ టు కలెక్టర్స్. అండ్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు అబ్టైన్ ద వోల్టేజ్ గెయిన్, ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు అబ్టైన్ ద డిఫరెన్షియల్ వోల్టేజ్ గెయిన్ AD, వి షుడ్ అప్లై KVL ఫర్ ద టూ లూప్స్. కన్సిడర్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఫస్ట్ లూప్, దిస్ ఇస్ ద సెకండ్ లూప్. This one is first loop, this one is second loop. Apply KVL for the first loop as well as apply KVL for the second loop. So what is KVL? Sum of the voltages is equal to 0 in a closed loop. So here we have 4 voltages, Vin, next voltage across Rin, voltage across small re, voltage across capital R. So that is Vn minus Ib1 into Rn. This is the voltage drop here. I into R, that is Ib1 into Rn represents the voltage, minus Ib1 into Rn minus small re into Ie1 minus capital Re into I. Here we are taking the current as Ie. So I, we can also take it as I as I 1 minus I 2. So next equation, that equation represents, that is next in next slide. So Vn minus Rn into Ib1 minus small Re into I1 minus capital Re into I. We are taking the common current as I is equal to 0. Consider this one as first equation. Next, similarly apply KVL for the second loop. So this is the second loop. We have voltage drops as Vn, the voltage drop across Rn, the voltage drop across small Re, the voltage drop across small Re, and here we have no voltage drop. So we, in this case also, we have four voltage drops. So that is, if you apply KVL, then we can get the equation as Vn minus Ib1 into Rn minus small Re into Ie1 minus small Re into Ie2 is equal to 0. So Vn minus Ib1 into Rn minus small Re into Ie1 minus small Re into Ie2 is equal to 0. So this is the second equation. So next, already we know Ib1 is equal to Ie1 by beta, Ib2 is equal to Ie2 by beta. Ib1 in terms, if you write the base current in terms of emitter current, then Ib1 is equal to Ie1 by beta, Ib2 is equal to Ie2 by beta. And what is Ie here? We are taking the current flowing through the resistance capital R as I. So this is the current IE. IE can also be written as, for the emitter resistance, we have two currents. Here, this is the current IE1, which is flowing through the resistance RE in this direction. And here also we have the current IE in the opposite direction. This is, for the first loop, we have IE1 current. For the second loop, we have IE2 current. So that is totally, we can get, for IE is equal to I1 minus I2. Those two currents are in opposite directions. So substitute IE is equal to I1 minus I2. Then the above equations becomes Vn minus R into, normally we have Ib1. So in place of Ib1, we have substitute I1 by beta AC. That means we should substitute I1 by beta AC. So that is Vn minus R into I1 by beta AC. Minus small re into Ie1 minus capital Re into Ie here. So Ie means Ie minus Ie2 is equal to 0. So just substitute in place of Ib1 as Ie1 by beta AC, in place of Ie as Ie1 by minus Ie. Then we can get the equation as, we consider this one as like third equation. Next, similarly, from the fourth equation, we can write it as Vn minus Rn into Ib2. Ib2 means Ie2 by beta AC. Normally we have Ib2 here, so that is Ib2, so just note that one. So Vn minus Rn into Ie2 by beta AC minus small Re into Ie1 minus small Re into I is equal to 0. This is the fourth equation. So already we know Rn by beta AC is very small value. Rn by beta AC is very small value, so that is Rn by beta AC is very, that is Rn is internal resistance. Beta AC means very large value. So that means the overall value becomes very small. So if you substitute this value in the above equation, then we can get the equation as Vn minus this equation. That means this term will be eliminated because here we have Rn by beta AC. This value becomes very low. That is small r. Next, if you eliminate this term, then we can get next term as minus small r into I1 minus capital R into I1 minus I2 is equal to 0. Similarly, Vn, we can also substitute R in here. So I1 here. So if you neglect this term, then Vn minus small r into I1 minus small r into I2 is equal to 0. Vn minus small re into I1 minus small re into I2 is equal to 0. So just substitute IE1. Here we have IB1 normally. So in place of IB1, we are substituting Rn into IE1 by beta AC. If you neglect this term, then we can get the equation as Vn minus small Re into I1 minus small Re into I2 is equal to 0. So if you consider the internal resistances, then we can get Rn1. Otherwise, we cannot consider that portion. So from this equation, if you simplify this equation, we have common terms of IE1, that is small Re into I1 minus capital Re into I1. If you common IE1 from these two terms, then we can get IE1 is equal to small Re plus capital Re. If you common IE1 from these two terms, then we can get IE1 into small Re plus capital Re minus. So we have minus Re into IE. Minus Re into IE2 is equal to V1. Just simplify this equation. Then we can get IE1 into small Re plus capital Re minus capital Re into IE2 is equal to V1. You can get some minus sign here. If you common that minus sign, then it will shift it to other side. That will become as positive sign. So that is, if you simplify the equation, then we can get the equation as IE1 into small Re plus capital Re minus capital Re into IE2 is equal to V. Similarly, from this equation, we can get IE1 into Re plus IE2 into Re is equal to V. So we have only IE1 and IE2 as single terms. So we need not common the terms. So that is IE1 into Re plus IE2 into Re is equal to V. Consider these two equations as 5 and 6 equations. So apply Cramer's rule. Already we know the Cramer's rule. So if you have the equations like A1x plus B1y is equal to C1, A2x plus B2y is equal to C2. A1x plus B1y is equal to C1. A2x plus B2y is equal to C2. Then what is x value? X value is equal to det of C1, C2, B1, B2. And denominator term, det of A1, A2, B1, B2. So from this equation, we can say that this is x. This is A1. A1x plus, this is B1. B1 means minus Re into y. IE2 is y. X is IE1 and y is IE2 here. Next, x coefficient is A1, y coefficient is B1, is equal to C1. A1x plus B1y is equal to C1. Similarly, A2x here, this is x, IE1 is x. X coefficient is A2 plus IE2 is y, y coefficient is B2 is equal to C2. So that is A2x plus B2y is equal to C2. Here x represents I1, y represents IE2. IE1 represents x value, IE2 represents y value. So what is x value? So that is what is IE1 value. IE1 is equal to det of C1, C2, B1, B2. What is C1, C2? C1 is Vn, C2 is Vn. So C1, C2 and B1, B2. What is B1? That is y coefficient. B1, B2. So B1 is minus Re, B2 is small r. Y coefficient, that is IE2 coefficients, minus Re, small r. Minus Re, small r. By det of A1, A2, B1, B2. What is A1 here? Re plus Re. And A2 is small r. Re plus Re, small r. What is B1, B2? Minus capital Re, small r. Minus capital Re, small r. So this is IE1 value. Similarly, IE2. So IE2 means y value. So IE2 is equal to det of A1, A2, C1, C2. A1, A2, C1, C2. A1, A2 means small Re plus capital Re, small Re. And C1, C2 means Vn, Vn. By det of A1, A2, B1, B2. Denominator is same for both the X and Y values. A1, A2, B1, B2. So that is Re plus Re. A2 means small Re. B1 means minus capital Re. B2 means small r. So det of B1, B2, C1, C2 by det of, det of A1, A2, C1, C2 by det of A1, A2, B1, B2. So this value represents IE. Next, if you simplify the equations, that is apply det for the numerator as well as denominator, then I1 becomes V1 into RE plus Vin into capital R. V1 into RE minus Vin into minus R. That is minus of minus plus. So that is Vin into RE plus Vin into capital R by denominator. Small RE plus capital RE into small RE minus of minus plus small RE into capital R. Small RE into small RE plus capital RE minus of minus. That is plus small R into capital R. So this is IE1 value. Similarly, apply that for the numerator of IE2. So that is small R plus capital R into Vn minus small R into Vn by small R into small R plus capital R minus of minus plus small R into capital R. So for the numerator, we have Vn into small r plus capital R minus small r into Vn by, for the denominator, we have small r into small r plus capital R minus of minus plus small r into capital R. So this is the equation of IE2. So if you find out the values of IE1 and IE2, and finally, we should find out the output voltage, V0. So what is V0? Here, we are taking balanced output. Balanced output means we are taking the output between two collectors. So we have the difference voltage, that is VC2 minus VC1. V0 is equal to VC2, that is voltage across C2 minus voltage across C1. What is voltage across C2? Voltage across C2 means, here we have the voltage. Voltage across C2 means this is the voltage at the collector C2. So voltage across C2 means the current is IC2 here, the resistance is RC. The resistance is RC, current is IC2. And what is voltage? RC into IC2. This is in downward direction. So that is in reverse direction. So that is, here we have, so, okay. Okay, downward direction, that is, here we have, here we are taking VC2. So that means common. So RC into IC2 minus, what is VC1? So VC1 means the current flowing through this resistance is IC1. The resistance is RC. V equal to IR. I means IC1 and R means RC. So here the current direction is in upward direction. Here we should observe the current directions. Here we are taking the voltage and the direction is from ground to the collector terminal. Current direction. So that means it is in reverse direction. So that means VC1 is equal to minus IC1 into RC. VC1 is equal to minus IC1 into RC. And as well as VC2 is equal to IC2 into RC, because here this current flows from upward direction to ground. So that is collector to ground, same direction. So if you substitute these two values, that is in place of VC2, we should substitute IC2 into RC. In place of VC1, we should substitute IC1 into RC, that is minus IC1 into RC. Then we can get RC into IC2 minus of minus VC1 means minus RC into IC1. So that is RC into IC2 plus IC1 minus of minus plus. So what is IC2 and IC1? IC2 is approximately IE2, IC1 is approximately IE1. So IE2 plus IE1. Already we know the values of IE2 and IE1. Just substitute these two values. If you simplify this equation after substitution, then we can get V0 is equal to capital RC into small RE plus 2 into capital RE by small RE into small RE plus 2 RE into V. That is capital RC into Vn by, at the denominator we have small RE plus 2, capital RC into small RE plus 2 RE into Vn by, at the denominator we have small RE into small RE plus 2 into capital RE. And for, already we know small re plus 2 re is approximately 2 re. Substitute that equation as or else if you cancel these two terms, then we can get this capital RC by small re into V. Capital RC by small re into V. And what is V0 by Vn from this equation? V0 by Vn is equal to capital RC by small re. What is V0 by Vn? The ratio of output voltage to the input voltage represents the differential gain, AV. So that is the differential gain is equal to capital RC by small r. So this equation represents the voltage gain of a single input balanced output differential amplifier. Next, what is the input resistance? So input and output resistances. Already we know the input resistance, that is, it is defined as the equivalent resistance that would be measured at either of the input terminal by maintaining the other terminal to ground. So input resistance ante entandi, manam edaina gaane oka input resistance find out cheyali anukunnappudu ఏ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ దగ్గర మనం ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తున్నాము ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, ఆ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ కి ఇన్పుట్ అప్లై చేస్తాము, సిగ్నల్ సోర్స్ ఇస్తాము, అదర్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ ని గ్రౌండ్ చేస్తాం, అంటే అదర్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ ఇన్పుట్ జీరో చేస్తాం. సో నార్మల్ గా ఇక్కడ మనం ఒక ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్తున్నాం, సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ అంటే ఒక ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్తున్నాం, కాబట్టి మనకి ఎన్ని ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ ఉంటాయి, ఒక ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ మాత్రమే ఉంటుంది. సో ఒక ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ మనం ఇక్కడ ఆర్ఐ అనుకుంటాం, ఆర్ఐ ఆల్రెడీ ప్రీవియస్ సెషన్స్ లో మనం ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేసాం. So, same అదే మేనర్ లో మనం కనుక ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తే ఆర్ఐ వాల్యూ ఎంత వస్తుంది, 2 బీటా ఏసి ఆర్. సో ఆల్రెడీ ప్రీవియస్ సెషన్స్ చెప్తున్నాం, సేమ్ అదే డెరివేషన్ అండి. జస్ట్ ఇక్కడ ఎన్ని తీసుకుంటున్నారు అనేది చూసుకోవాలి ఫస్ట్. ఇక్కడ మనం సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి ఒక ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటుంది, ఆ ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ వాల్యూ 2 బీటా ఏసి ఆర్. నార్మల్ గా 2 ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ ఉంటే ఫస్ట్ ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేయాలంటే అదర్ ఇన్పుట్ సోర్స్ జీరో చేయాలి, సెకండ్ ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేయాలి అంటే ఫస్ట్ టెర్మినల్ ని అంటే ఫస్ట్ టెర్మినల్ దగ్గర వోల్టేజ్ జీరో చేయాలి, ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ వోల్టేజ్ జీరో చేయాలి. సో ఇక్కడ ప్రాబ్లం లేదు, ఒక ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి ఒక రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటుంది, అది ఆర్ఐ. ఆర్ఐ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2 బీటా ఏసి ఆర్. నెక్స్ట్ అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్. సో అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఈస్ ద ఈక్వలెంట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ దట్ వుడ్ బి మెజర్డ్ ఎట్ ద అవుట్పుట్ ఎట్ ఐదర్ ఆఫ్ ద అవుట్పుట్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు గ్రౌండ్. సో అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ అంటే అవుట్పుట్ దగ్గర ఉన్న రెసిస్టెన్స్, దాన్ని ఎలా ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తారు, విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు గ్రౌండ్ తో ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తారు. సో నార్మల్ గా ఇక్కడ మనం హియర్ వి ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్, దట్ మీన్స్ వి కెన్ హావ్ టు అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్సెస్. సో ద ఈక్వలెంట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ దట్ వుడ్ బి మెజర్డ్ ఎట్ ఎదర్ ఆఫ్ ద టెర్మినల్స్ ఈస్ ఆర్సీ. వి హావ్ ఆర్సీ ఫర్ బోత్ ద ట్రాన్సిస్టర్స్, దట్ మీన్స్ ఫర్ బోత్ ద ట్రాన్సిస్టర్స్ వి హావ్ ద అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ యాజ్ ఆర్సీ. అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ అంటే అవుట్పుట్ దగ్గర మనం ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేస్తామండి. ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ Q1 ని మీరు తీసుకుంటే, సో Q1 ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ కి అవుట్పుట్ ఇక్కడ తీసుకుంటున్నారు, Q2 ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ కి అవుట్పుట్ ఇక్కడ తీసుకుంటున్నారు. సో అంటే ఇది అవుట్పుట్ టెర్మినల్. సో అవుట్పుట్ టెర్మినల్ దగ్గర ఎన్ని రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ ఉన్నాయి, ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ కి ఒక రెసిస్టెన్సే ఉంది, దట్ ఈస్ ఆర్సీ 1 ఆర్ ఆర్సీ. సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ కి అవుట్పుట్ దగ్గర ఎన్ని రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ ఉన్నాయి, ఒక రెసిస్టెన్సే ఉంది, దట్ ఈస్ ఆర్సీ 2 ఆర్ ఆర్సీ. అంటే టోటల్ గా బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ అంటే 2 టెర్మినల్స్ యూజ్ చేస్తాం, అంటే మనకి ఎన్ని రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ వస్తాయి అవుట్పుట్ లో అంటే 2 రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ వస్తాయి, దట్ ఈస్ ఫర్ ద ఫస్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ వీ హావ్ ఫస్ట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, ఫస్ట్ అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, ఫర్ ద సెకండ్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ వీ హావ్ సెకండ్ అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, దట్ ఈస్ RO1 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు RO2 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు RC. దిస్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ ద AC అనాలసిస్ ఆఫ్ సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ కాన్ఫిగరేషన్. నెక్స్ట్ సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ అన్బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ యాంప్లిఫైయర్. సో సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ మీన్స్ హియర్ ఆల్సో వీఆర్ అప్లైయింగ్ ఎ సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ V1 for the first transistor, and for the second transistor input is 0. That means simply we are connecting the base terminal to ground, and we are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. We are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. This is the configuration of single input unbalanced output differential amplifier. So ఇక్కడ మనం ఒక ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్తామండి, ఇంకొక ఇన్పుట్ జీరో చేస్తాం, అంటే దీన్ని గ్రౌండ్ చేయాలి. నెక్స్ట్ అవుట్పుట్ అన్బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ అంటే ఒక ట్రాన్సిస్టర్ దగ్గరే తీసుకుంటారు విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు గ్రౌండ్, ఎలా అంటే ఇక్కడ ఇక్కడ తీసుకోవచ్చు ఇక్కడ తీసుకోవచ్చు. సో హియర్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ అవుట్పుట్ అట్ ఓన్లీ వన్ కలెక్టర్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు గ్రౌండ్. నెక్స్ట్ దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఏసీ ఈక్వలెంట్ సర్క్యూట్ ఆఫ్ సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ అన్బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ యాంప్లిఫైయర్. సో ఇన్ ద సిమిలర్ మానర్ వి షుడ్ ఫాలో ద రూల్స్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు అప్టైన్ ద ఏసీ ఈక్వలెంట్ సర్క్యూట్. So what are the rules? First one, the DC sources should be zero. That is VCC and VEE should be zero. These are the DC sources. Next, substitute the equivalent model for both the transistors. That is in place of Q1 and Q2, we should substitute the T equivalent model. So if you substitute those, the T equivalent model, and as well as if you maintaining the DC sources as zero, VCC and minus VEE is zero, then this is the equivalent circuit of the fourth configuration. This is this portion represents the T equivalent model for the first transistor. This portion represents the T equivalent model for the second transistor. So for the first transistor, we have the three terminals: base, collector, emitter. So for the collector, we have the collector resistance RC. the current flowing through this resistance is IC1. For the base terminal, we have two components, R in one and V in one, and the current flowing through this base terminal is IB1. Next, we have the emitter resistance at the emitter terminal. This is the emitter terminal. This is the emitter terminal. We have the emitter resistance capital RE, and we should take the internal resistance small RE also. So that is appear here. So here the resistance is small RE. This is the T equivalent model. Next, this is the T equivalent model for the second transistor. For the second transistor also, we have three terminals. This is the collector terminal of second transistor. Emitter is common for both the transistors. So here we have common RE for both the transistors. This is the emitter terminal of second transistor. Capital RE is the emitter resistance of second transistor. Small RE is the internal resistance of second transistor. Emitter resistance, internal emitter resistance, small RE. And for the base, we have no components. So that is base is simply connected to ground. Base is simply connected to ground. Next, for the emitter, sorry, for the collector, we have the collector resistance RC. The current flowing through this collector resistance is IC2. So this portion represents the second transistor T equivalent model. So for both the transistors, we have only a single source, that is V in one, and the current directions are from this voltage only. That means this is the current direction and this is the current direction. Next, RC other terminal is connected to ground, and as well as RC other terminal is connected to, because here we have normally VCC, VCC becomes zero. As well as here we have VE, VE becomes zero. That means this should also be connected to ground. So next, what is the output voltage? Here we are applying a single input and we are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. This is the output part. Here we are taking the output at only one collector. This is C2, collector terminal of second transistor. We are taking the output at this collector with respect to ground. So this represents the AC equivalent model of fourth configuration. And consider, this is the first loop, this is the second loop. First loop and second loop. So apply KVL for the first loop. If you apply the KVL for the first loop, we have four voltage drops. So that is V in one minus R in one into IB1 minus small RE into IE1. Normally we have the current at this terminal as IE1, and minus capital RE into IE1 minus IE2. IE1 minus IE2, or we can also take it as IE, the common current as IE. So normally we have four voltage drops here. So this is the equation. V in one minus R in one into IB1 minus small RE into IE1 minus capital RE into IE, where IE is the difference of two currents, IE1 minus IE2. We have two currents for the emitter resistance which are flowing in opposite directions. Here we have IE1 current, here we have IE2 current. So those two currents are opposite directions. So we have the total current as IE1 minus IE2. This is the KVL for the first loop. Apply KVL for the second loop. So if you apply the KVL for the second loop, then we have four voltage drops here also. V in one and R in one voltage drop, RE voltage drop, again RE voltage drop, and this is zero. So that means V in one minus R in one into IB1 minus small RE into IE1 minus small RE into IE2. This is the emitter resistance of second transistor. That is the current in this terminal is IE2 and the current in this terminal is IE1. This is the internal resistance of first transistor. This is the internal resistance of second transistor. Here we have the current IE1. Here we have the current IE2. So V in one minus R in one into IB1 minus small RE into IE1 minus small RE into IE2 is equal to zero. Consider this one as second equation. Substitute to IB1 as IE1 by beta AC, IB2 as IE2 by beta AC, and IE means IE1 minus IE2. So if you substitute these values, then we can get the equation as V in one or V in, both are same because only here we are applying only a single source. So that is V in minus R in into IE1, IB1 means IE1 by beta AC minus small RE into IE1 minus capital RE into IE1. IE means IE1 minus IE2 is equal to 0. And again, V in 1, R in 1, we are applying only single source, and the internal resistance also same. That is, R in 1 is R in, V in 1 is V in. And again, IB1 means IE1 by beta is E minus small re into IE1 minus small re into IE2 is equal to 0. Already we know Rn by beta is E is very small value. So this term will be neglected because this term has Rn by beta is E and this term also neglected. Then this equation becomes Vn minus small re into IE1 minus capital Re into IE1 minus IE2 is equal to 0. And from this equation, we can get Vn minus small re into IE1 minus small re into IE2 is equal to 0. And here we have the common terms, that is IE1 terms. So just common IE1 from these two terms, then IE1 into small re plus capital Re minus capital Re into IE2 is equal to Vn. This is the direct equation. That means we have some minus and plus signs changing. That means here we have the actual equation as minus IE1 and we have plus and we have minus. If you common, then the terms will be cancelled. Then final equation is IE1 minus small r into small r plus capital R minus capital R into IE2 is equal to V. And from this equation, we can get IE1 into small r IE2 into small r is equal to V. That means minus of this term is equal to minus V. Minus minus cancel that. We can get IE1 into RE plus IE2 into RE is equal to V. Just simplify this equation. So these are the two equations which we have. Consider these equations as three and fourth equations. Apply Cramer's rule for these two equations. Already we know the Cramer's rule. So these two equations are in the form of A1X plus B1Y is equal to C1. A2X plus B2Y is equal to C2. What is X here? IE1. What is Y? IE2. So A1X means this is A1, this is X, plus B2Y means this is B2, this is Y, is equal to C1. This is C1. Next. A2X, this is X value, IE1, A2 means RE, B2Y. This is Y, this is B2, B2Y, is equal to C2. So by using the Cramer's rule, in order to get the IE1 value, in order to get the X value, so at the numerator, we have det of C1, C2. So here we have IE1 is equal to det of C1, C2, B1, B2. At the numerator, we have det of C1, C2, B1, B2. Denominator, same. Det of A1, A2, B1, B2. A1, A2, B1, B2. So here we have C1, C2 as B in B and B1, B2 as minus RE, small RE. IE2 quotients. So that is here we have minus RE. Here we have small r. This is IE2. IE2 coefficient small r. So minus r, capital r, b1, b2, c1, c2. So again, denominator a1, a2, b1, b2. A1 means x coefficient small r plus capital r. And here we have x coefficient as small r. So that is this is a1, this is a2. And this is b1, this is b2. IE2 coefficients minus RE capital R. So this is IE1. Similarly, IE2 is equal to det of A1, A2, C1, C2. A1, A2, C1, C2 by det of A1, A2, B1, B2. A1, A2, B1, B2. So apply that for the numerator and the denominator and simplify that. Simplify the equations for IE1 and IE2. Then finally, we can get the equations as IE1 is equal to Vn into small r plus Vn into capital R by small r into small r plus capital R plus small r into capital R. And similarly for IE2, Vn into small r plus capital R minus Vn into small r by small r into small r plus capital R plus small r into capital R. So this is the current, so currents we have, that is IE1 and IE2. After obtaining the currents, finally we should find out the output voltage, V0. So what is the output voltage? Here we are taking unbalanced output. Unbalanced output means we are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. In this case, we are taking the output at collector C2. We are taking the output at collector C2. Okay. So what is the voltage drop at collector C2? We have the current IC2 here and the resistance is RC. The current direction is same direction, that is downward direction. So that is V0 is equal to IC2 into RC. V0 is equal to IC2 into RC. This is the voltage drop at collector C2. And What is IC2? IC2 is approximately equal to IE2. IC is equal to IE. So substitute IE2. So already we know the value of IE2. So substitute this IE2 value in this equation. Then finally, V0 is equal to RC into Vin into small RE plus capital RE minus Vin into small RE by small RE into small RE plus capital RE by small RE into capital RE. And finally, we have the equation that is small RC into small R, capital RC into capital RE into Vin by small RE into small RE plus 2RE. Just simplify this equation. Then we can get the V0 value as capital RC. This is RC. Capital RC into Vin by 2RE. Capital RC into Vin by 2RE. Substitute RE plus 2RE as 2RE. Because RE plus 2RE is approximately 2RE. This is the internal resistance. This is very low compared to this this resistance. So this value is approximately 2RE. Substitute 2RE and RE, RE will be cancelled. Then we can get the equation as capital RC into Vin by 2RE. So from this equation, V0 by Vn is equal to capital RC by 2RE. V0 by Vn is equal to this capital RC by 2RE. V0 by Vn represents the differential gain AD. So AD is equal to RC by 2 into small r. This is the differential gain or voltage gain of single input unbalanced output differential amplifier. Coming to the input and output resistances. For this case, we are applying a single input. So that means we have only a single resistance. That is Ri is equal to 2 beta AC Ri. Next, what is output resistance? For this case, we are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. That means output terminal is one terminal only. So that means we have only one output resistance. So that output resistance is R0 is equal to Rc. That means at the collector C2, we have only a single resistance with respect to ground. So that is R0 is equal to Rc. So input resistance okate untundandi single input istunnam kabatti that is 2 beta ac re it already derived chesam previous sessions lo annitiki okate namo derivation same input resistance ki kakapothe manam enni teeskuntunna enni inputs iste 2 inputs iste 2 input resistances osthe single input iste single input resistance osthundi next alage output resistance kuda annitiki same suppose meer balanced output teeskunte two collectors degara output teeskuntunnaru kabatti two output terminals unnattu meeku టూ అవుట్పుట్ టెర్మినల్స్ ఉన్నాయంటే టూ రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ వస్తాయి టూ అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ వస్తాయి అన్బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ అంటే ఒక కలెక్టర్ దగ్గరే తీసుకుంటారు అంటే ఒక అవుట్పుట్ టెర్మినలే ఉంటుంది ఒక అవుట్పుట్ టెర్మినల్ ఉంటే ఒక అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ వస్తుంది అలా అన్నమాట సో సింగిల్ ఇన్పుట్ కాబట్టి ఒక ఇన్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటుంది అన్బ్యాలెన్స్డ్ అవుట్పుట్ కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ ఒక అవుట్పుట్ రెసిస్టెన్సే ఉంటుంది సో ఆర్ నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద AC analysis of fourth configuration, single input unbalanced output configuration. Next, properties or comparison of four configurations. So normally this is the comparison or properties of differential amplifier. So normally we have four configurations: dual input balanced output, dual input unbalanced output, single input balanced output, and single input unbalanced output. And here we have the comparison. Here we should draw some circuit diagram related to this. Differential amplifier. For the dual input balanced output, we should draw the circuit there. For the second configuration, we should draw the dual input unbalanced output differential amplifier. Similarly, for the third and fourth configurations also, we should draw the circuit there here in this column. And next, for this column, we have the differential gain. Already, we find the values of differential gain for all the four configurations. So. For the first configuration, differential gain is RC by 2RE. For the second configuration, we have the differential gain that is RC by 2RE. For the third configuration, we have the differential gain that is RC by RE. For the fourth configuration, the differential gain is RC by 2RE. This is the differential gain which we have already find in the found in the previous slides. Next. Fourth comparison, input resistance. For the dual input, we have two input sources. That means we are applying two inputs. We have two input resistances. That is Ra1, Ra2. Ra1 is 2 beta AC Re. Ra2 is 2 beta AC Re. And in this case also, we are applying two inputs. So two input resistances we have. Ra1 is 2 beta AC Re. Ra2 also 2 beta AC Re. Next, for the third configuration, we are applying a single input. Single input means we have only one input terminal. That means we have only one input resistance. that is Ra1 is equal to 2 beta SARE. And in this case also we are applying a single input, and hence we have a single input resistance, that is Ra1 is equal to 2 beta SARE. This is the input resistance column. Next, output resistance. So for the dual input balanced output configuration, we are taking the output between two collectors because this is balanced output. So that's why we have two output resistances, RO1 and RO2. RO1 is RC, RO2 is also RC. Next, for the second configuration, that is unbalanced output. Unbalanced output means we are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. So that means we have only one output resistance, R0 is equal to RC. And in this case, balanced output means we are taking the output between two collectors. So that's why we have two output resistances, RO1 is RC, RO2 is RC. And for the unbalanced output, we are taking the output at only one collector with respect to ground. So that means we have only one output terminal. So we have only one output resistance also. That is R0 is RC. This is the output resistance for. So this is the comparison of dual in differential amplifier. We have four configurations, and for the four configurations, we have the individual equations. And next, features of differential amplifier. So what are the features? What are the advantages of differential amplifier? What are the properties of differential amplifier? What are the main important features of differential amplifier? Means, first one, the differential voltage gain is high. That means the voltage gain. The differential voltage gain is high. Differential voltage gain means the gain with which whenever we are applying some two voltages, different voltages to the differential amplifier, the gain which we have at the output, that is known as differential gain. So that gain is high. Differential voltage gain is normally represented as AD. So differential gain ante entante manam normally differential amplifier ki two inputs ichinappudu aa two inputs kanaka different inputs aithe appudu vache output appudu vache gain edaithe untundo dan differential gain antam ante different signals ni adi amplify chesi output ga isthundi appudu vache gain differential gain. So adi ekkuva untundi normal ga differential amplifier ki differential gain ekkuva undali ante difference ni ekku amplify cheyali ichina input signals yokka difference ni ekkuva amplify cheyali. Next, common mode gain is low. Common mode gain ante so if you are applying same signals to the two inputs of two differential amplifier, then the gain which we have is known as common mode gain. That gain should be low. Ante common signals ichinappudu, same signals ichinappudu differential amplifier em cheyali, ekkuva amplify cheyagaladu. Ante common signals kabatti compulsory ga ideal ga em avvali, zero, because same signals ichinappudu difference anedi zero avutundi kabatti ideal ga zero, practical ga ento kontha ostundi, but common signals ichinappudu ekkuva amplify cheyagaladu. Average anedi ekkuva amplify avagaladu, adi takku undali. So common mode gain takkuva untundi. Next, CMRR is also high. CMRR means common mode rejection ratio. That is the ratio of differential gain to the common mode gain, AD and AC. So that should also be high. Ante CMRR kuda ekku untundandi. Ante AD by AC value ni CMRR tho represent chestamu. Differential gain deen prakaram ekku undi, common mode gain takku undi, kabatti automatically CMRR ekku untundi. Next, input impedance is also high. Input impedance means the impedance at the input, the resistance at the input is high. Next, wide band, the bandwidth of differential amplifier is also high. Next, low offset voltages and currents. That means if you are not applying any input to the differential amplifier, the output should be zero. So that should be low. Ante manam em even appudu input differential amplifier ki output ఏమి రాకూడదండి, ప్రాక్టికల్ గా ఎంత కొంత వస్తుంది బట్ అది తక్కువగా ఉండాలి. సో ఎంత తక్కువగా ఉంటే మన సర్క్యూట్ అంత బాగా ఎఫిషియెంట్ గా వర్క్ అవుతుంది. సో దట్ ఈస్ లో ఆఫ్సెట్ వోల్టేజెస్ అండ్ కరెంట్స్. అంటే ఆఫ్సెట్ వోల్టేజెస్ కరెంట్స్ తక్కువ ఉండాలి. ఆఫ్సెట్ వోల్టేజ్ అంటే ఇన్పుట్ ఏమి ఇవ్వనప్పుడు అవుట్పుట్ అనేది ఏమి రాకూడదు ఐడియల్ గా, ప్రాక్టికల్ గా ఎంత కొంత వస్తుంది ఆ వచ్చేది కూడా తక్కువ ఉండాలి. నెక్స్ట్, అవుట్పుట్ ఇంపిడెన్స్ ఇస్ లో, ద ఇంపిడెన్స్ అట్ ద అవుట్పుట్ ఆఫ్ ద డిఫరెన్షియల్ యాంప్లిఫైయర్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో. So these are the features of differential amplifier which we have. So thank you.